Hunger, disease, increasing poverty. The human condition was degenerating in poor countries and the developing world. Ill, healthy, threatened adults and children population, with some dying before the age of 5. Mothers were dying at childbirth. As children out of school roam the street, with some into child labor. In some poor countries, potable water and sanitation became a luxury. This appalling situation caught the world's attention, and global leaders reminisced on the threat to decent human existence. Thus birthed the Millennium Development Goals, otherwise known as MDGs.
The Millennium Development Goals are structured, identifies the basic needs of individuals, of the poorest in our society, and challenges governments to try and work with society to fulfill these needs.
The MDGs are 8 international goals that were established following the Millennium Summit of the United Nations in 2000, as well as the adoption of the United Nations Millennium Declaration. The MDGs caught the world's imagination from the very day they were agreed by a record 189 countries and 23 international organizations at the United Nations General Assembly in September 2000. They agreed to achieving the 8 goals, and Nigeria was an enthusiastic signatory as its deprived and poverty-stricken population was on the upswing. The aim of the MDGs is to encourage development by improving social and economic conditions in the world's poorest countries. The MDGs were made to 18 to meet some targets and 48 indicators to measure progress towards poverty reduction in order to achieve the goals set forth in the declaration, a 15-year timeline. The 8 Millennium Development Goals include eradicate extreme poverty, improve maternal mortality, combat HIV/AIDS, malaria and other disease, ensure environmental sustainability, access to safe drinking water and sanitation, as well as develop a global partnership for development. Nigeria, a signatory to the declaration on the MDGs, has 36 states, with Plateau State being one of them, and is located in north central Nigeria. The state has a temperate climate with an estimated population of over 3 million people, and its demographics make it an eager partner with the MDGs.
I make bold to say that The presence of government in the local areas is felt much in the area of MDG projects. A lot of our community people know more about MDGs because the presence of MDGs to them represents the presence of government. And I think that is where we've been able to get a lot of assistance from the governor of Plateau State, because MDG is dear to him, and he knows that that is the only area the presence of government can also be felt, apart from the efforts that other MDAs and also the government is doing. So to us on the plateau, we've been very lucky. Since 2011, we've been having the local government and state tracks. 2012, we have the local government and the state track. 2013, we have also the local government and the state track. The local government is the one that is ongoing. Very soon, the state track will be on board, and also the local government track with the additional 6 local governments that we've had. So by and large, by 2015, even though I know that we may not be able to reach all the communities, but significantly, at least we have registered our presence in most communities on the plateau.
Plateau State has 17 local government areas, with most of them rural-based, apart from Jos, the state capital, Barkinladi, Bassa, Jos East, Jos North, and Jos South, as well as Riom local government areas, which are in Plateau Northern Senatorial District. The Central Senatorial District is made up of Bokos, Mangu, Panshing, Kainke, and Kanam, while the South has 6 local government areas comprising of Wase, Mikang, Shendam, Kwanpan, Langtang North and Langtang South local government areas. Though the administration of Governor Jonah Jang, which came into office on May 29, 2007, has rooted its development agenda on rural urban areas, the prompt payment of counterpart funds to the MDGs has fast-tracked service delivery to the nooks and crannies of the state. Projects are sited in communities based on a rigorous assessment exercise involving citizens of such places.
We've tried as much as possible to ensure that the community are also involved. And don't also forget that before we site projects, there's this baseline facility inventory and needs assessment that our technical assistants usually do. And they do it in conjunction with the communities. But one thing that we have also tried to do is to ensure that in the process of our commissioning, we involve the community. And we use that as an opportunity to also tell them what they are expected to do.
This has seen the delivery of critical infrastructure, equipment, drug and other services in water and hygiene, health, education, poverty reduction, and maternal health care training. Under the state track in 2008, 68 motorized boreholes with gatehouse and fence were drilled and constructed across the state, as well as equipping an equal number of PHCs in 4 local government areas of the state. This has reduced the vulnerability of the number of benefiting communities to waterborne diseases, as most sources of water they were using were not safe.
Usually we have thematic areas that Plateau State usually intervene. One in the area of health, in the area of education, in the area of water sanitation, in the area of empowerment. And I can tell you that we have done well in all these thematic areas. In our state tracks, we also concentrate on these thematic areas.
The scope of work expanded in 2009 to cover motorized boreholes, renovation of primary health care clinics, equipping of 96 clinics, and drilling of hand pump boreholes. During the period, 68 motorized boreholes with gatehouse and fence were constructed in different locations in the state. In addition, hand pump boreholes were drilled. The Plateau State Millennium Development Goals Office intervened through the construction and renovation of 96 primary health care centers, which needed a facelift, and also equipped same number to make them functional and meet the needs of target communities.
Before the construction, they were not finding it easy. They travel afar to get medical care. So, because before the construction, there was an existing primary health care center. So when it's burned down, they find it difficult. They have to travel to Riompo for their medical care. So the construction of this clinic brought a big relief. And thanking God, because they are getting their health need as easy as possible.
Between 2011 and 2012, The Plateau MDGs executed and delivered more quality projects to selected communities.
The community, they are very impressed about the clinic, because before we were managing with a very small bungalow, but by now we've gotten a very nice and fantastic place now. We offer family planning, malaria tests, and every type of diagnosis.
Iska wana clinic ya ba mu dadin rayuwa su kare da mu wanda ya buya dame mu ba za mu yi nisa ba sai mu samu mu tsaya kusa a warkar da mu.
In fact, we are enjoying the equipment very well, especially the solar refrigerator and the beds and the drugs. Even the drugs that they supply, we are enjoying the drugs too. The mattresses, even the vehicles, ambulance, is helping the people in the locality very well.
The tempo of work in the water and sanitation sectors under the Millennium Development Goals was stepped up in 2011 as the state track provided 68 additional motorized boreholes with gatehouse and fence within the state. Under the local government track, which was introduced in 2011, educational infrastructure were increased in some communities in three pilot local government areas of Mikang, Kainke, and Riom. A two-classroom block was constructed in 11 schools in Panshin local government, with the same number in Barkinladi. Barkinladi also enjoyed the provision of three classroom blocks office and store at LEA Primary School, Rahay, and the construction of one VIP toilet and four separate LEA primary schools there under the 2012 intervention. This is in addition to the construction of a block of two classrooms in nine primary schools in Barkinladi. There was also a boost in the area of water and sanitation, as 11 hand pump boreholes were drilled in Barkinladi and 18 in Bassa during the same period.
Muna shan wannan ruwa yana kawo mana dama. Sometimes yara makaranta ma sai sun gangara rafi, sai su je rafi. Wani lokaci ma ko an buga kararrawa during break ba za su samu zuwa in time ba saboda wannan damuwar ruwan. So da mun ga wannan, gaskiya muna farin ciki sosai, kuma zai taimake mu domin yara za su dawo ga makaranta kusa. To Allah ya sa ma ya zo fado kusa da makaranta da kuma asibiti mu yara dan kasa. So gaskiya muna godiya, zai taimake mu.
The gains of the state track were further consolidated in 2012. The Plateau State Office of the Millennium Development Goals constructed 36 motorized boreholes with gatehouse, which was complemented with the drilling of 77 hand pump boreholes across needy locations in the state. The improvement in the health sector in Plateau State, being powered by the Governor Jiang administration, is being complemented by the State Office of the MDGs. Under the state track in 2012, four new PHCs were constructed in needy locations, while 85 primary health centers spread across the state were renovated. Some of the PHCs also equipped with ambulances, making them able to address primary health challenges at the grassroots level. Addressing the direct needs of some communities, the MDGs under the local government track was able to successfully touch the lives of people of some communities in Lantang South, Bassa, Jos East, and Barkinladi. Other benefiting local governments are Lantang North, Kwanpan, Kanam, and Jos East.
This is to ensure that our children also get qualitative education even in the villages. I therefore, on behalf of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, and also the Plateau State Government, hand over these books for onward distribution to the primary schools that desire it and for the betterment and for the use of our children. Congratulations, sir.
Areas of intervention include construction of primary school classroom blocks, supply of books, teaching aids, and dual desks.
The life after, before this building was very, very tough for us, as teachers and students as well, because before this building we were sitting on stones, that is the pupils. They were just sitting on stones. They have never had an experience of sitting on the desk until now. So I think it's a very good motivation.
They also benefited from construction and equipping of new PHCs and the sinking of solar-powered boreholes, as well as the drilling of hand pump boreholes. In a bold move to reduce the incidence of maternal and child mortality, especially among rural communities, the Plateau State NDGs conducted training for village health workers in Plateau State.
This training is relevant and strategic in view of the important role of village health workers as a link between the communities and health services centers available in our localities. This volunteer group is expected to enlighten the communities on the availability of medical services, facilities, basic household practices, and prevention of diseases, with the ultimate goal of promoting healthy living in our families.
In Plateau State, the MDG's intervention has conveyed government's presence to some areas that had hitherto not received attention.
I want to really take this time to appreciate the state government coming in collaboration with the United Nations, trying to see that they improve on the life of the citizens of Plateau State. And our governor has been a father. Aware of the counterpart funds that he has been releasing, so that this development is attained.
The need to implement the 8 MDG goals, and which are also akin to the state goals. You know, the state government under the John Ajang administration have 10-point agenda. And they key into what we call the MDG goals now. We want to eradicate poverty, provide infrastructure, provide health accessibility, provide education. And so the driving force was, the state government had programs that relate to the MDGs. But the MDGs intervention also was also a boost to the state. It was just a support to the state, the existing programs to eradicate poverty, and to enhance education, gender equality, provision of infrastructure, and the rest.
This is a step that has given most of the benefiting communities hope and reduced the stranglehold of poverty on them.
Lalle da na zauni muna zama ne kawai cikin halin da muna ganin kamar manta da mu. To ba zato sai kawai muka ga MDG sa tura mutane suka zo suka fara mana renovation na wannan clinic din.
Executing the MDG's mandate in Plateau State is one that the management has done with diligence and patriotic zeal. The barrister Peter Nyamgai, late management, has remained resolute in monitoring projects to ensure quality delivery.
The modalities we use in checking contractors whether our project are to specification or not, we normally have a team of engineers in the unit that do go around We have what we call on-the-spot monitoring. We have weekly monitoring, which we get feedback from our desk officers and various local government. We have monthly monitoring, in which we write report and we send it to Abuja on monthly basis. We also have random monitoring and quarterly monitoring. That's the one that we used to undertake with the state project coordinator. Actually, the jobs that have been executed in Plateau State, from the rating from the external consultants which are engaged and the CSO, that's a non-governmental group, at least Plateau State is one of the best in terms of qualities, because most of our projects, at least they stand the test of time.
The management constantly tours project sites across the state, and this has resulted in quality delivery of jobs. To ensure effective monitoring, the Plateau State MDG's office has also distributed motorcycles to its desk officers in the 17 local government areas of the state. The MDGs has made concerted effort at poverty reduction. Apart from encouraging people to improve on their living condition, they have a program, the Conditional Cash Transfer CCT scheme, targeted at the vulnerable.
Basically, the conditional cash transfer scheme was conceptualized in such a way that quite a number of the MDG goals can be met within one single program. We start first of all by identifying local governments that are supposed to even benefit from it, because the scheme was conceptualized or introduced so that you try to reach out to what we might consider the poorest of the poor within communities. So a poverty index was taken in relation to the local governments in Plateau State and also across the country to select local governments that become beneficiaries of the CCT scheme. Then after that, we now move down to the community level, and at the same time similar criteria in terms of identifying some of the most remote and backward communities in the within those local governments, so as to select the communities that will be beneficiaries.
In Plateau State, 90 households are benefiting in 5 communities in each of the target local government areas, namely Jos East, Riom, Barkinladi, Kanke, and Mikang. To some people, the monthly stipend of 5,000 naira to each of the benefiting households may not be anything, but for the beneficiaries, it is a turning point.
I duly prepare a grant for that 5,000 not to be misused. As for now, as I say it, I know of the 10,000 I pay the school fees of my children and those of living with me. And the rest of the 4 months, each month I do buy a goat so that if the problem come and occur, I can sell it and manage the family. And the goats, they are there with me now. So really, I'm appealing to the government, if a government have any source to add more time and to add more beneficiaries onto this program, really is really helping us in this community and people living in the area like this. Really, this 5,000 is something in our life. It's touching our life and it's changing our life. It's, unless if somebody don't want to use it in appropriate area, that is what. But to me, I wonder if the program will be a life program.
War da na biyan kudin makaranta na gode kowan wata.
Mun gode sosai.
The conditional cash transfer has also brought joy and happiness for others while hoping for it to be sustained.
Mun gode abinda mun kara muna dan amfani da shi a cikin abinci muna samu mu ci. A cikin amfanin gwana muna samu dan yin amfanin gwana da shi.
Godiya ga wannan kudin da muka karba. kun taimake mu gwamnati sun taimake ni saboda yayan makaranta muna samu muna biyan yaran mu muna biyan bukatun kanmu kuma mun gode kurai mun gode ma gwamnati da suka taimake talakoki
ni gwamnati ne ta zo ta same mu daga gida nke ga taimakon da sun kawo mana sai sun doke mu sun bada su form mun cika su form din sai suka ba mu su waya suka ba mu waya to sun je sun yi magana da cewa mu wayan da za a ba mu kula da waya mu rike da kyau kada mu zubar da shi ba mun yadda shi damuwa ne yanzu abin da muke da shi shine zai taimake mu ga biyan bukatan yaran saboda kuɗin makaranta da abin shi da abin da za mu iya mu taimake kare kanmu da shi
The MDGs may not have met all expectations, but its management and implementation in Plateau State has restored hope and trust in some public institutions.
In terms of project implementation, we are not doing bad. In fact, in CGS 2013, both local government and state, by the last assessment, Plateau State, we are about 97%. But I can assure you, virtually all our projects have been completed, bearing in mind that we have just very few, and we're determined this time around to complete all our projects. So by and large, by 2015, even though I know that we may not be able to reach all the communities, but significantly, at least we have registered our presence in most communities on the plateau.
We are now marking 1,000 days to achieving the Millennium Development Goals. The MDGs are the most successful global anti-poverty push in history. World poverty has been cut in half. More girls are in school. Child mortality has dropped. We are fighting killer diseases. The list goes on.